Hi, I'm Nick Kowalski, holistic wellness coach, and today I want to talk to you about the three treasures. So in traditional Chinese medicine, practitioners look at the body in sort of three different universes or three domains, and these are Jing, Qi, and Shen. They are substances or energies that basically make up us as a whole, so the mind, body, and the spirit. So if we were to break each one of these down, while there's no exact English translation, we could look at roughly Jing being our essence, Qi being our vitality, and Shen being our spirituality. So we need all three of these to be optimally healthy. When we don't have enough Jing, it affects our Shen, it affects our Qi, vice versa. They're all interconnected. However, to be optimally healthy, we want optimal levels of all three of these energies. And oftentimes, they can become depleted through our life, through lifestyle, through our diets, and various other factors can affect these energies. However, understanding a bit of each of these three treasures on a deeper level might help you understand how they're affecting you in your body, and even where your energy levels might stand, and how bringing these into balance could affect other areas of your life. So looking very basically at Jing, we see that Jing is our essence, and this is our most primal energy. Jing energy is most closely related to our body. It's responsible for creativity. And I don't just mean thought, but physical creativity. So it is our Jing that is responsible for our ability to procreate and reproduce. And we see this on the physical level that our Jing is said to be stored in our kidneys, which is where our reproductive fluids are created basically. So we find that when we have low Jing, not only does our physical vitality start to decrease and affects our Qi and our Shen, but it also affects our ability to think creatively, to come up with creative solutions to our lives. And overall, we start to become fatigued. So low Jing could mean, on a physical level, anything associated with like sexuality, so a low sex drive. It could mean hair loss or skin problems, muscle waste, and because of our adrenal glands sitting right on top of our kidneys, low Jing could be, you know, a symptom of stress, and vice versa. If we don't have enough Jing, then we are likely to be more stressed out in situations. So Jing is depleted mostly through stress, worry, and anything in excess, really. Particularly in Chinese medicine, Jing is depleted through sexual or excessive sexual behavior or ejaculation in men, excessive hormonal irregularity or menstrual irregularity in women, or through many births or having many children. But naturally, Jing is going to be depleted through our life, but there are things that we can do to actually replenish our Jing. So we have prenatal Jing, which is our constitutional Jing. It's basically the energy we were born with. In a Western perspective, we could see like this might be where our hereditary or genetic system sort of comes from. But in Chinese medicine, it's really just a quality of physical energy that's transferred through the sperm during conception. So this prenatal Jing is basically the level of health we're born into. However, we have postnatal Jing that can be built or lost through lifestyle. So we can actually build up our postnatal Jing with practices like Qigong and herbs and diet and other lifestyle behaviors. And by building up that postnatal Jing, we can actually not only reserve our prenatal Jing, but actually even kind of like leak that postnatal Jing into our prenatal Jing, which is going to overall just help us age more gracefully. So going into Qi now, we find that Qi is basically that physical manifestation of Jing. Qi is our vitality. It's, you know, we find our Qi created in our lungs and our spleen. And this is why we see in the practice of Qigong or Tai Chi a lot of breathing, and that our breath is really the what moves our Qi throughout our body, and also our blood, because if we're breathing well, we're directing circulation. And so really we see that Qi is derived from our breath, the quality of our blood, which is gonna go right back to, you know, what it is that we consume on a daily basis. Our food can either rob us of qi or give us qi. So diet and exercise is the basic practices that we could, or exercises that we could engage in to build up our qi. And this is why we see people in the West putting a lot of importance on eating the right foods and doing the right exercises, because most of us understand that if we eat right and we exercise right and we practice good sleeping patterns, that we actually have more energy. And this, from an Eastern perspective, is just us building up our qi, which is going to directly affect our quality of health and our levels of Jing, because through the practice of inner alchemy or Taoist sort of tradition, we're really just directing, we're using our consciousness to direct our qi and either build more Jing or more Shen energy. So again, to summarize, qi is really just our vitality. We build it through tonic herbs, through exercise, particularly energy building exercise like qigong, and really just more importantly, stopping that leakage of jing. So like removing stress, not eating foods that deplete us of jing and qi. And last but not least, we have Shen, which translates to spirit. So it's our spiritual radiance. We could see Shen as, you know, sort of our higher consciousness. It's in Chinese medicine, it's our true self. So it is our awareness, our pure awareness, which has, you know, a non-judgmental sort of objective view of our lives. And this is why we find usually people who are more of an enlightened state have higher levels of Shen, which is the goal of Taoism and Chinese herbalism and medicine, is really to cultivate Jing and Qi so we can create more Shen or spiritual radiance, so that way we are more tolerant, we're more forgiving, we're more accepting. In a Western perspective, we're more chilled out and relaxed, and we don't worry and we don't stress out over things. We don't have a lot of problems. So that Shen energy is really, it's stored in the heart in Chinese medicine. And really, in order to have a lot of Shen, we need to have our hearts open so we can experience this higher consciousness of ours that really understands that we're all connected, and how we behave affects another person. And as the Buddha said, having resentment is like drinking poison and expecting the other person to die. And this is sort of a Shen quality, to understand that for you to experience anger, hate, resentment, all these things, you're only harming yourself, not others. So through this understanding, we understand if we forgive ourselves, we can forgive others. The more we forgive others, the more we forgive ourselves. And that really, no matter what, we cannot escape the fact that we as beings and human beings are all connected. And again, to cultivate this sort of understanding, this higher consciousness, this sort of wise perspective, is in Chinese medicine directly correlated with our levels of Shen energy, which could again be traced back to how much Jing and Qi we have. In layman's terms, healthier people, healthier bodies tend to have higher levels of, you know, Shen energy, and so a greater ability to not be stressed out, to forgive others, to be relaxed, to be understanding, and so on. So the goal is then to, of course, increase all of these energies, to not really be imbalanced in one or the other, because they're all effective. They all affect each other. And so we have, you know, Chinese herbs that help build these treasures up. We have specific tonic herbs that build Jing, like Hoshu Wu and Goji Berry or Lycium. We have certain herbs that build Shen energy, like Reishi. Their cordyceps can help build our Qi. And taking all these different herbs on a consistent basis can help bring up these energies. And then, of course, practicing, you know, Qigong or other Taoist traditions and just basic healthy living habits can, of course, build our energies and help us achieve an enlightened state with far less effort. And of course, the healthier we are, the healthier the planet is. So these are the three treasures in a nutshell. Hopefully you found this information helpful. If you want to learn more about the three treasures, you can search infinite amounts of information on the internet. There's Chinese medicine practitioners you could study with. And of course, this is a 3,000 plus year old tradition. There's a lot to learn. So do your own research, find out things for yourself. Again, I'm Nick Kowalski. You can learn more here. So subscribe to our channel, and thank you.